Resilience for me is the ability to adapt, to thrive under challenging conditions. And I don't think we've ever seen that more so than the last 12 to 18 months. Like many of you, I'm a parent. And I think probably the best example I can think of resilience is how our children have had to adapt to education and learning through this period. My children had to, I'm sure like many of yours, learn from home. And I saw two very different experiences. One of my children, their school was very quick to embrace video conferencing. And the challenge really that they had was, in most instances, the students actually knew more about the tools and how to use them than the teachers. And as such, we had to help educate the teachers to better manage that classroom, that online experience. But there was a great outcome that came from that. In my second child's school, they had a very different experience. For months, they tied themselves up around the thought of the security vulnerabilities in video conferencing tools, the concerns around privacy and safety, both for the students and the teachers. In the end, it had a positive outcome, which was we were able to step back and review their broader policies and controls and how they adapt and change those at pace. But I think there were some key takeaways, hopefully, that we can all learn from this. Technology is a great enabler, and it certainly has helped all of us to stay in contact and communicate, to be resilient in what's been a very tough period. But to leverage that to get the maximum value, there's definitely a skills and education piece. And of course, we can't forget the RSA theme here, which is cybersecurity. And cybersecurity is almost, in many ways for me, a paradox in resilience. When we do it well, it can be a huge enabler of how we achieve resilience. When we do it badly, it can be more disruptive than the very problems we're trying to solve.